You look and see where the gaps are. The biggest gap right now is in front of
All right, we got four laps to go in the ARCA race.
He's trying to figure out what kind of run his car can carry. He's got a car that he knows wants to move with Jackman behind him. You know, what is that run going to happen? What are they going to take? And more than likely, their spot is working here. So grab on the spot, Jack. What's Spock say? Let's let Jackman maybe a little bit of a run. Go with me and see what we can do.
When is the right time to make that move?
Whatever you have, I'm not a fan of waiting until the last lap because some other caution could happen, something could happen, and if you're ready for one shot, one try, it's probably not going to be enough. So I think if you have the run, you got to take it, and if you have help, you got
to take it. Three to go.
Because everybody else starts getting patient, as you see another reasonably sized gap in front of the 23 car.
That was Jesse Love's family on the right side and his crew chief, Shane. This car that Jesse's driving actually won this race here 2 years ago. I mean, when you're as good as Venturini Motorsports, especially when it comes to super speedway races, most of your cars, if not all of them, have won at some point in the last few years.
You were talking about Scott Melton right now running in the sixth spot. That's the car that Todd Gilliam won here a few years ago. Taylor Gray, he's going to jump to the outside of Sean.
Make a move now. Can't wait.
We're on the start finish line here. Two laps to go.
I wish
as you
the
mentioned.
Field wasn't so spread out, but oh well.
18, though. Taylor Gray out there by himself.
When you're the last car in line, you don't have anybody behind you. It doesn't matter how fast your car is. Obviously, all the Taylor's is pulling the A car off the field. They're going to have a tough time really being able to keep up with this lead pack. I mean, I think Sean Corr would be wise just to get behind. Don't try to sidetrack them. Don't try to pull them back. Get them lined up, get behind them, or they're going to find themselves in the clutches they got behind them. Now they're going to be frustrated with each other because they don't really have a shot to win. Now this pack's smaller, and now it's going to be even harder for Jack Wood and Brett Holmes or Perez to create a run.
Single file and column up front, but back in the pack, three wide.
Here we go. This is it.
White flag is in the air.
Here we go.
Gus Dean, Andres Perez, Brett Holmes, and Jack Wood.
You see a little bit of a gap. Brett Holmes is backing up to Jack Wood. I wonder if they backed up too far. They don't have Obviously, Jesse Love has quite a few cars in between him to be able to make the right move, the right block. Here comes Brett Holmes. He does have a little bit of momentum. He does pull out the rest of Kentucky. Mainly on the outside as well. Gus Dean's going to jump out of line for a moment. Now pulls back in line. Here comes Brett Holmes.
Here we go.
Jack Wood with him on the outside.
More of it. He goes back in line.
Blocks all the way to start.
Of course, he decided to wait till the last
Jesse
lap.
Love in the 20, 18-year-old from Redwood City.
Not
going to
get there. Jesse Love wins at Talladega.
What a happy crew chief and Shannon Rush right there.
And just really well executed race. Well executed restarts. And obviously, the pack was too small for the other guys to generate their own. But the rest, Jesse, that whole group, they didn't learn that much.
I mentioned earlier, Billy Venturini, the team owner, is out in Kern for the West race. And I said, Shannon, are you in charge? He said, well, I guess so. So, get your lane.
So good for Jesse. Love, well, such a competitor.
So much for making a move. So I make a move before it's too late. Golly.